This is a spiritual crystal card reading for the month of October for Taurus. So let's see what this month has to give to you and how you can use the energies. So have a look. Taurus, October. This is Spinel. Spinel. This means acceptance. Acceptance, so accept who you really are. Love yourself as you really are and keep on working is also on it. It means like keep on going, you are on the right track, keep on doing and work on the acceptance and love yourself as you truly are. Let's see the second card are two cards. Second card for October for Taurus. The first one is opal. Opal, what means mirroring. And the second one, this is very interesting actually, and the second one is black tourmaline. What the black tourmaline actually means is transforming your negative thoughts, your negative energy, or the energy around you into positive. So I think you have there to go deep into yourself and use the mirror. You can maybe use other people as a mirror, you know, when you see other people are actually disturbing you, their actions are actually disturbing you. Or maybe sometimes it can happen that only to be in company of this person, it makes you nervous, it makes you tense. Well, this time it is a good opportunity for you to have a look inside of you. What is it what disturbs you? Because it is mirroring of negative emotions, so that you can learn to love yourself as you truly are. So this is very interesting. Let's see what the first week. Now we're going to go a little bit more in details. But that's the main energy of the month. So using mirror technique for to find your deeper lower emotions, I would say, things that you want to work on, because this is actually holding you back for to accept yourself as you truly are. So have a look. Let's go to the first week of October. This is aventurine, beautiful hearthstone, and it means inner growth. It's inner growth. So you go into yourself and you start really to work on yourself. You start to have this inner growth, growing the deeper self, the deeper you to come out. This is nice. Let's go for a second one. Second card on the inner growth. It is tiger eye. Tiger eye, that means don't focus only on one direction. There are more directions. So have a look on this inner growth. Don't only focus on one point. There are more points of what you can use as your purpose for to reach this inner growth, for to reach the heart. And the aim of inner growth is actually very beautiful, because this means that you get in contact with your higher self, that you are this higher being. And this is very, very nice actually, when you see how it is with through this mirroring, that you can come to this point. And don't get stuck on one. You say, oh, I can't see it. This is one road and I can't see what's going on. Try a different method of approach then. Let's see, later on I will tell you which crystals you can use, which meditation you can use, but let's go on a little bit for to see a little bit more about the whole month. So we have the second week of October for you, for Taurus. This is Dioptas. Dioptas is a beautiful green crystal. And you can see we are keep on going up to the heart level. Right? This it is, I think it really has to do with love yourself as you truly are, your true self loving. And this means a new beginning. There are new beginnings for you, so a new time is opening for you, something new is coming to you. So let's see in which direction. Let's go like this. in which direction it is meant that this new beginning for the second week. This is Labradorit. Labradorit. This means that you will go inside of you, you will have this deep look inside and you will find new things in you. Maybe qualities that you didn't know that you had when you have been transforming maybe fears or insecurity or thinking that you can't do this. And then if you are transforming this and you come into this first week and you see that there are other ways how to deal with situations, maybe you come into this second week and you will see that there are new openings are coming, new things are coming, because you actually are preparing the path. The path is going. You are on this path of transforming, and then new sides of you are relevated. They are coming up and you say, wow, can I do this? Or wow, this is me, and oh, look at this, what I can do. These are, and then you have this opening and these deeper insights. Really nice. Let's go to the third week. Let's see where the stream is going. Third week. Yeah, two again. Third week is silver. Silver, I would say, with silver, when in this reading, I would say, have a look maybe on your qualities as creative qualities. What is it what you want to do in life? What is your creative? Where is your creative side? What is it what you're thinking of changing or having a new beginning? And use your creativity. Use your creativity, because there is something here. This is the Sugilit. Yeah, Sugilit. Pink Sugilit. What actually says to you, there is something, third week, there is something actually with what you are fighting. And it is holding you actually back, I would say, it's holding you. And in the third week you will be confronted with this, it may be an inner fight, something that you have to end, something that is going on for a long time, and it is time to move forwards. So, to let it go. It's time to let it go. So you have here this, go into your creativity. Find what is your power, where is your power, in which, what are you good at, what are your strong points. Instead maybe, because you will look at your negative, but you don't get stuck in the negative side. It's just, you have a look at, let's say you don't have any confidence in yourself. I just give an example. You don't have any confidence in yourself. You won't stay there and say, oh, I don't have any confidence in myself. This is not the thing. You will, through the mirroring, you will be aware about this. And then you go into your inner growth. Then you go into the heart chakra. And you're going to work about on this. And you're going to work on your confidence. So why don't you have any confidence in yourself? It's the why then, you know, the why in what do you don't have. And then you go deeper into this. Let's say that you use the aventurine for to meditate with. And I don't have one here, but it's a beautiful green. And aventurine is a relatively cheap stone. It's not expensive because you can find it a lot. So it's easy for you to get an aventurine. Meditate with the aventurine. Keep the aventurine in the palms of your hands and just close your eyes. Allow the energy to go through the palms of the hands into your whole body, to come into the heart, and through, when it is in your heart, you connect with the stone. You ask the stone to share its energy and allow the whole green energy of the aventurine to go through the whole body as well and centered in the heart. And there you stay for a while and you try to see there. You try to feel there. What is holding you back? What is in the way for you for to go forwards? So when you have this, when you have found this, when it comes up, you can see that there are different ways to deal with it. It's not only one way how to deal with it. There are different ways. So let it loose. Let it loose. And through letting it loose, for example, you will see that there's a new start for you in ahead as well. You have the possibility to do something new. Through the possibility of doing something new, you will collect more information about yourself. You will acknowledge yourself better, and there your self-confidence may really start to grow. I use self-confidence as an example. It can be different themes, okay? So your self-confidence may start to grow there. So you can also see that using your creativity is actually a strong point of view. It helps you maybe to lighten up. It helps you to de-block, to find that there are other ways again, because through different art, you can do art, you can theater, singing, drawing, so many things, dancing, and through this way of maybe coming out, you will understand that your true potential, how strong you actually are. That you really can love yourself as you are, because you are a beautiful being with a lot of positive sides. So that you start to let go of what is actually always disturbing you and holding you back. Sorry, that was not Sigrid, it's Kunstzied. It's Kunstzied. So Kunstzied. If now you have difficulties with changing and with moving your path into another direction, while you, for example, you feel that you are stuck, you can use the Kunstzied. The Kunstzied, you can make a meditation with the Kunstzied the same way as you do with the Aventurine. It's actually always the same way to start the meditation with a stone. It's through the palms of the hands, allow the energy to come for the whole body and centered in the heart, and open the heart for the energy of the stone and communicate with the energy. So allow the impressions to come. It can be through impressions, it can be through feelings, it can be through pictures, it can be through words, but this all is coming into you, and like this you can connect with the stone. And here with Kunstzied, for example, you can ask Kunstzied, you can ask this stone to show you where you are actually stuck, or where you are blocked, or how can you finish the best this way of, it can be a programmation of years, a habit of years. So how can you stop this habit to be there, to be always to holding you back and not allowing you to have this self-confidence that you should have, self-confidence of or something else, but what actually at the end holds you back to love you, love yourself and accept yourself as a true strong being and light being as you are. Let's go to the fourth week of October for Taurus. This is beautiful, this is Rubini, it's Ruby. Ruby, that means open the heart. Go with your open heart, that means go full trust into what you have chosen to do is the right thing. So you will go through a transformation, through letting go of the past, a habit, I would say, a way of being, let it loose, let it go. Go into this deep inside of growing your inner child. Allow it to connect with your inner child and to grow with your inner child. And see that there are more ways as only one way. Then you will see through this realization, there will be a new beginning for you, which will allow you to understand yourself even more as you did till now. Go into your creative side. Use your creative side. And if there are things that hold you back, like you feel like you cannot go over it, use kunst for to meditate with it and to open the path. You will see that in the fourth week your heart will be open, because you start with the heart stone and you end with the heart stone. So you start on this inner growth the first week and you end up at the fourth week with opening the heart and being ready for the new things to come to you, even if they already come. But when your heart is open, then you will see things are very fast coming to you. So I would leave it there. It's very beautiful. So if you decide to work on yourself and you do this, you will see after 4 weeks you will have a really good result, and you will have cleaned some sadness maybe, or some unsatisfaction. It's not really sadness, because it's not really sadness in this, but there is some unsatisfied feeling of not having the whole you, not accepting the whole you. There are parts in you that you don't accept, that you don't like. So through working on them and accepting them, through seeing what actually how beautiful you are, you will see at the fourth week how good you will feel. That's very nice for you. So let's see, I'm just going to ask one message in general for you, one message for October, an extra message for you for October. And this is Alexandrite. Alexandrite, what's Alexandrite is, I use it as a karma card. It says, give yourself time. And everything what have to happen, will happen. Will happen in this time. So it doesn't make any sense, excuse me, to force it or to go against it. And when it has to happen, it will happen. And it will happen in its time. You can also see it. Work on it now, because if you don't work on it now, maybe you will have to work on it in the future. So, use this karma card as a push for to go forwards. So, I thank you very much, and may love and light be with you. Enjoy this month. Thank you. Bye.